Hello, my name is Charlie Pittner, and this is my nonprofit speech audience. Imagine spending the winter without a coat. Personally, I don't like the cold, and I hate to be cold. But sadly, in Lubbock, Texas, one out of every five children lives below the poverty line. That is about 19.8% of the population here in Lubbock. So I'm going to be talking to you about Charlie's Kids for Kids Coat Drive, which is a nonprofit that I started whenever I was 6 years old. And I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the kind of help that we are needing and how the community can help make this project better. I'm going to persuade my audience to volunteer for Charlie's Kids for Kids Coat Drive. I'm a credible source for this information because I've been working on this project for over 12 years, and I've been leading this project since I was 6 years old, so I understand the help and the benefit that the help would give Charlie's Kids for Kids Coat Drive. So the main points I'm going to be talking about today are financial needs, community support, and manpower. So let's go over the first one. So some of the financial needs that this nonprofit needs. A lot of people have donated money to us before, and we use that to go out and donate coats, or to go purchase coats to donate. So one way that this project could use a lot of help, besides the actual donation of coats, is the donation of money. So we could use money. All of the money that we receive goes directly back into the project. So any money that we receive can go back into this project and buy coats for those who need it. Another way that the coat drive can be supported financially is to receive financial relief from local businesses. One way that we have been relieved locally by businesses is with the printing of all of our posters and receiving free boxes from Office Max to help make our drop-off location boxes. That is another way that our project could use help. Instead of having to take money out of our own pocket towards this project, we can use the community so that local businesses are also giving towards a good cause, and we are also reaping those benefits. So my second point is the community support from citizens and businesses. So the way that every person can volunteer is by donating a coat. So if I open this up, this past year we had 9 drop-off locations in Lubbock, Texas, and they're pictured up here. They were all across town. So like I said, one way that every single person in Lubbock could help or could volunteer for this project would be by donating a coat to one of these drop-off locations. That's such an easy thing. You go home and you look in your closet and there's coats that don't fit or haven't fit in years. You go and you take those to one of our drop-off locations, and those will be put to good use. I also said community support from businesses, and while we're on the topic of drop-off locations, over the past 12 years, we've built connections with different businesses across town. So one way that our nonprofit could be benefited is by gaining more support from local businesses and adding more drop-off locations. So that would actually increase the number of coats we're getting, because those businesses also have posters about our project during the time that the box is there, so we could get more coats donated. And then the last point is manpower. There's a lot that goes in behind the scenes of this project. So my first point, like you saw at the picture on the front of the poster, we have to put all of the boxes together every single year and wrap all of the boxes. We have about 15 to 20 boxes that we have to put together and wrap and put posters on and tape every single year. So we could use people to help with that. And also another way that we could use manpower is I have some pictures over here of the sorting process during the coat drive. We get an influx of around 800 to 1,000 coats every single year, and those need to be sorted into sizes, and then we put them into bags and give them to the people who take the coats. And that's a long process. A few years ago, it was just my mom and I, and it took us days, even weeks, to get all of the coats sorted. So that is another way that we could benefit from some volunteer work. So I kind of went through the solutions to each of those. My plan of action, I have 5 points. Reach out to news platforms and reach out to followers on Facebook. That will help us gain attention on social media. We could cold call businesses to help gain support for drop off locations or donations of boxes and wrapping paper, tape, etc. Number three is reach out to family and friends for support. This would help if people don't live in town, they could donate money for us to buy coats, or they could come and help sort or put boxes together or drop boxes off at drop off locations. Number four would be to get more drop off locations. Kind of ties into number two of cold calling businesses. We could reach out to local businesses and see if they're willing to help us with this project. And last but not least is strengthen our presence on social media. So we run an Instagram page and a Facebook page, and that is where we get a lot of attention. So the results of all of this volunteer work is going to include an influx of coats donated and more awareness brought to the project. So more kids, people getting the coats, more people will get the coats and be kept warm during the winter. But also a consequence of not taking action and not reaching out for help would be less coats donated if there's not as many drop-off locations. And also, it could be a waste of time or money. Like time and money resources could be wasted with all the time and not as many people getting help. So kind of an overview of what I've been talking about are 3 points why you should volunteer for us is it would benefit our financial needs. We could gain community support and help raise more coats, and we could also gain manpower and help make everything more efficient. So my goal today was to persuade my audience to volunteer for Charlie's Kids for Kids Coat Drive. And a way that you can do this is reach out to us on Facebook or on Instagram at Charlie's Kids for Kids Coat Drive. Thank you, and this is my audience.